Fed up with a boring looking stream that the PS5 limits you to? Well, what if I told you that you can stream your PS5 gameplay using Streamlabs or OBS instead without the need of a capture card? This will then let you fully customize your streams with different scenes, transitions, alerts, overlays, music, and so much more in order to keep both you and your viewers entertained for longer. First, you'll need to set up a second user on your PS5 with another PSN account linked to it. I'll fully explain why this account is necessary in the pinned comments, but it essentially acts as a link between your PS5 and OBS, whilst you then use your usual account to play the games that you want to stream. Once that second account is on the PS5, go to that account settings, then users and accounts, then down to other and enable console sharing and offline play. You can now switch users back to your main account. Don't log out, just switch user. Next, head on over to your PC or laptop and make sure you have either OBS or Streamlabs OBS installed, so I'll leave download links to them in the description. I'll be using Streamlabs in this tutorial, but the setup process is essentially the same with standard OBS. With the streaming software installed, you'll also want to install PS Remote Play for your device, which I will have linked in the description too. Once PS Remote Play is installed, open the software up and you'll be prompted to sign into your account. To avoid any lag on the stream and completely bypass any input lag to your own gameplay, you want to sign into that second PSN account we just made, not your main account. I have left a more in-depth explanation as to how the second account does this in the pinned comment, so whilst you read that, do leave your own comment letting me know what platform it is you're wanting to stream to, whether that's Twitch, YouTube, or something else entirely, as well as the game that you're wanting to stream. I really want to know. When you've signed into Remote Play, simply select a PS5 option to connect to your console and follow the instructions that the app gives you. Then wait whilst the connection to your PS5 is established. After a few seconds, your PS5 screen should be shown and you are now connected to your console. The quality and frame rate of a PS5 stream you see here is adaptive, so it alters to provide the most stable video your connection can handle. That should usually be 1080p 60fps, which looks great. If you pick your controller back up and turn it on, you'll notice that you're not playing on the second account, but you're playing on your main account. That's exactly what we want here. Once we have the stream set up, therefore, you can just go back to your usual display and play as you normally would do. You'd have no idea the stream was even currently taking place if you weren't the one hosting it. That's how seamless this method truly is. Before getting to do that though, you might see a Remote Play connected message at the top of your PlayStation screen that doesn't seem to go away. Luckily, it can be removed by going to settings, then system, then language, and changing your language to something else to then change it right back to your usual language. I'm really hoping this is removed or we get a toggle in a future PS5 software update though, as it's quite annoying that it is even there in the first place. Anyway, now that we've got that sorted, your PS5 is fully set up to be streamed, so I'm going to walk you through getting the stream set up and started in either OBS or Streamlabs. Again, I'll leave links to download both in the description. Before opening your streaming software of choice, it is critical that you do not minimize the Remote Play window, as if you do, this method might not work. So just open up the software and don't touch the Remote Play window at all. I'm going to be using Streamlabs for this video. With your streaming software open, we'll first quickly change some of the settings by clicking the settings wheel at the bottom left and then go into the video tab. I recommend you set both the base and output resolutions to the same values as your PS5 is being streamed at, that being 1920 by 1080. Now go down to common FPS values and adjust this to 60. If you ever experience any lag or dropped frames on stream, you can drop this down to 30 and decrease your resolution to try to fix it. With the resolution and FPS values at 1080 and 60, we now need to add everything to the stream. On the left of the software is where we create the different scenes that we can switch between. I advise you rename the default scene to PS5 and then focus on the sources section in the middle. This is where we can add all the different elements of the scene. In fact, let's begin here by adding your PS5 screen. Do that by clicking the add icon, then select window capture. You should then call this window capture PS5 and then under window add remoteplay.x PS Remote Play and then uncheck the option to capture the cursor. Leave everything else on the default options and click done. You should now see your PS5 screen on the stream preview. How awesome is that? If you don't see it, double check that you didn't minimize the Remote Play window by selecting it on the taskbar and then just clicking outside the window window anywhere on Streamlabs and then try adding it again. If it still doesn't appear on screen or is not full screen, then right click on it, go to transform and click fit to screen. Next up, let's add your voice to the stream. You can do so by looking at the mixer section and clicking on the settings wheel next to the mic/aux audio section, then hitting on properties. Here you can change your device using the drop down menu. The only options here are mics connected to your PC or laptop, so if you don't have one, you will need to plug one in or use your headset. Personally, I like to use the Fifine K658. It is an incredible microphone for content creators and streamers of any size at a great price point too. And if you are curious as to what it sounds like, well, it's what I'm using in this video right now, and it's what I have been using for the last couple months in all my content. The unboxing experience is superb. Not only do you get the mic, but it comes alongside a desktop stand and shock mount. And it works with just a single USB to USB-C cable, so there's no annoying tangling mess like with XLR mics. To top it all off, it's got RGB lights too. Freaking RGB lights! RGB lights on a microphone this good is awesome, it just looks so good. Oh, and you see this little wheel here? Well, that lets you change the gain on the fly, and the touch sensitive button in the middle is a quick mute button. I love this microphone so much, and for less than $100 right now, it's the best microphone I could recommend to anyone. If this is a little out of your budget though, the T669 or K780A are great budget alternatives, coming with a full arm, pop filter and pop shield at only $60. I'll have all these different mics linked in the description, and if you do pick one up, let me know in the comments what you think of it and I'll definitely reply. Now if you do only have access to one microphone but want to be able to speak in a PlayStation party and also get that party audio on the live stream, you will need to disconnect your mic from your PS5 and plug it directly into your PC. Most headsets will work with the wireless adapter they give for USB ports, but you might need to use a cable instead. With it connected, go to settings, then system, then sound, and put your output set as your headset and change the default input to the headset's mic. You'll now hear the PS5's audio, but you won't yet be able to hear and speak in the party chat. To do that, go to the remote play window and click the mic icon to unmute the remote play microphone, and then join the party on the second account via remote play, keeping your main account in the party too. All the party audio should now be received on your PC and you'll be able to speak to your friends. Now go back to the audio settings in Streamlabs and you can choose your headset to be your microphone or your own dedicated mic, which is of course what I recommend and do myself. It would honestly just be better for you and your friends to be speaking via Discord as well though, and then capturing that as part of your PC's desktop audio. Right, with all the basics out of the way then, we can now polish up the look of your streams to get everything looking professional and perfect. If you want to add an overlay to your scene, hit the add icon next to sources, and then add either a media source or PNG image, depending on what sort of overlay you have. Adding music and other things like a webcam follows the exact same process, so it's quite self-explanatory. For example, if you want to add alerts for when someone subscribes or donates or whatever, then add an alert box and customize them from there. I recommend adding alerts of some sort, as it can encourage extra donations and subscribers, as the viewers interacting knows they will get some recognition on the stream. Another thing you might want to do is add different scenes depending on what you are doing. You could do this to switch between a full face cam and a face cam window with gameplay, but I like to use it to switch between be right back screens and stream starting soon screens. You add different scenes just by clicking the add button on the scenes tab and then customizing all the different sources as we did earlier with our other scene. Note that you can drag layers above or below each other too, really easily just with your mouse. Now if you are using different scenes, you need to have a custom transition for when you switch between them. As you can see right now, I have a nice slide animation that plays whenever I switch between my scenes, and it makes everything look and feel much more professional. If you want your own transition like this one or any other 2D transition, then check me out on Fiverr. My transition gig has an average 5-star rating, so you won't be disappointed by it, I guarantee it. I'll leave a link in the description and I'd just love to work with you. With all that stuff added now, look at how much better your streams are going to look now than they did when you were just using a built-in PS5 streaming feature. Of course, this is not the absolute best way to stream, as you may still experience some lag if your internet isn't decent. You ideally want a minimum of 20 megabit per second as both your upload and download speeds, but not to worry, you can still get this professional look even if your internet isn't quite that fast. If you are in that situation, I recommend you use a ClonerAlliance Flint 4K P Pro capture card, as it passes through a full 4K 60fps HDR signal and can capture recordings up to a full 1440p 60fps or even 4K 30fps. At 1080p 1080p is even capable of capturing your gameplay at 120fps. It's a solidly constructed product, and the level of professionalism comes off in the unboxing experience too. After you spend just 5 minutes setting it up for the first time, you won't have to touch it again either, so it's extremely convenient. You can feed your microphone audio straight through it too, so that you don't have to spend ages syncing your mic with the gameplay, which is something a lot of capture cards don't have, and it is priced lower than the competing capture cards. To make all that even better, it comes bundled with some free video editing software and a USB-C to USB 3.0 adapter so you can use it with your phone. That's right, you don't even need a PC to use this to capture your gameplay or stream it. You can do it all from your phone. It's crazy. Even though my internet can easily handle the remote play method of streaming, I still always use this exact capture card as it's more convenient and allows me to stream and capture my gameplay at a high quality for my viewers. I'll leave links to this product in the description for you to check out for yourselves, and again, if you do pick one up, let me know in the comments and I'll heart and try to reply to it. Despite everything seemingly set up now, before you can go live, open up the settings menu one last time and go to the stream tab. Here, ensure you are signed into the account that you want to stream to. Both YouTube and Twitch are supported, but you can add any destination by selecting the custom ingest option. Once that's sorted, go to the output tab, change the output mode to advanced, then under the streaming tab, change the encoder to the latest hardware option you have. This should allow for a smoother stream with fewer frame drops. As you are already using quite a bit of bandwidth with remote play, you should change the rate control to VBR and then set the bitrate and max bitrate to whatever your internet can handle. I'd first try 2500 and 5000, but if you have any problems, keep bringing both those numbers down by 500 until the problems stop. You can then move it back up slightly until you find a perfect sweet spot for your own network. If you have zero problems to begin with, then feel free to put the numbers up too. Just have a proper experiment with these options by streaming privately to yourself or a friend. Once you're happy, just click done. But wait, that's still not it. One final thing to do before going live is download the Streamlabs deck app on your phone and link it up to Streamlabs. It'll let you change scenes, mute different audio sources, and all that fun stuff whilst you're live. You will be playing with your main account on your usual display you'd play your PS5 on, just as normal while streaming, and I imagine not many of you do that with multiple monitors around you. So this is an easy way around not having Streamlabs visible all the time on another screen. But with all that said and done, you can finally click the great big go live button and stream to the world, whilst you sit there playing just as normal as if the stream was coming straight from a PS5. If this has worked for you, please drop a like and consider subscribing to see more cool things you can do with your PlayStation consoles. If you do have any problems with the method though, ask your questions away in the comments and I'll see what I can do to help, as well as watch the video on screen now to see how you can double your PS5 FPS with just one setting. The results possible from this are mind-blowing.